Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of the New Jersey Craft Beer Review, Episode 5. Today, we're going to be checking out Frozen Pasture by Bolero Snort Brewery in Richfield Park. I want to welcome everybody to... I'm Chris Swenderman with my esteemed colleagues, Chris Anucci, Dan Tantillo, and our man Frank Cerno. So, Frank, what do we got on tap today?
So, the Frozen Pasture is a winter warmer style of beer, which is kind of malty... not real hoppy, a little bit of citrus, stone fruits. It's brewed exclusively with glacier hops, which is a little punny there for the winter warmer brew. And it's got an alcohol percentage of 8.5%.
So, you feel nice when you have this.
You'll feel it nice. Yeah. But you see, it pours nice and dark. With a nice foamy head.
Nice little foamy head on it. Yep.
I'll be honest, I've never even heard of winter warmer as like a style of beer before.
Yeah, I mean, usually it's like around Christmas or holidays, and then it's usually spiced. So this is an unspiced version.
It's a seasonal brew, and normally they're very malt forward, I guess.
Okay.
So Bolero. Do you guys know what Bolero is?
No.
Anybody? I looked it up. It's a Spanish dance, actually. So, and then the snort, they have all this bull imagery. So we have the art on the can here.
Yeah, I think it's a dance revolved around bullfighting. Right?
Okay.
Is that correct?
That makes sense.
Yeah.
I only researched it a little bit.
There's a classical piece called Bolero.
So why didn't you speak up when I asked? Yeah.
See? Apparently he knew more than he was letting up.
Yeah, so if you look at all their names, like Frozen Pasture, all the names escape me, but it's all bull related, all bull puns, you know, and the glacier, same thing. So,
really cool looking can, though.
Yeah.
Very cool.
I really like it.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, so, all right, so why don't we get into this? Let's check out the color first. So, very dark.
It's pretty dark.
Yeah. It's like, you know, mahogany, brown. You can get a little bit of light through it, you know, at the bottom, but
it's pretty dark.
A little bit of head that we had on it, but it's dissipated pretty quickly.
Very quickly, yeah.
Yep. So, it will smell.
Yep.
So, toasty, malty.
Get a lot of malt.
Maybe a little bit of the orange and cherry. And I don't know, they said that they're going for, I don't know if it was what they were trying to do or it was just kind of like a happy result, but like an old-fashioned cocktail. So like the muddled cherry, you know, the sugar, bourbon.
Right.
So okay. Do you think we get that in the smell? It's very subtle.
I can get a little bit of fruit, but it's definitely very subtle.
Maybe a little bit more cherry than... Orange.
Yeah,
right.
So,
yeah. Hey, you guys ready?
Right.
Cheers. So, what was the ABV?
8.5%.
So, it doesn't taste
8.5 at all.
No.
That's dangerous.
That's sneaky.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Definitely sweet.
Very sweet, malty. Maybe a little chocolate.
A little chocolate, just a hint. And it's pretty smooth. It's not like really like a full bodied, thick winter brew. You know, it's kind of medium bodied, you know, smooth.
Yeah,
smoothness to it. Yeah.
What else?
Definitely get the cherry, like a cherry aftertaste. Get a little bit of a cherry aftertaste.
You know what? It's almost like fruitcake. Like the cherries that would be in a fruitcake.
Molasses-y, brown sugary sweetness. Yeah, definitely.
Good call.
I think it really, like, sticks. Like, there's a stickiness to it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I didn't know what winter beer was before. This literally tastes like winter.
Winter beer, right.
Like, I feel like I'm at home by a fireplace.
Yeah. It's got a great essence of winter.
That's right, around the bearskin road.
That's right.
8.5%, you know, you don't have anywhere to be. Just sip it by a fire.
Yeah. This is definitely a home beer. You're having this at home. You're not going out to the bar or whatever it is.
That's right.
So, Yeah, so Bolero Snort, they are known as gypsy brewers, right? So they don't actually have a facility. They kind of skip around and brew at other brewers' establishments. So that's a pretty cool thing. Been around, I think, maybe 3 or 4 years. And this was on our list of the 12 best winter beers. So if you want to learn more about this or other winter beers, make sure you check that out. But we'll finish these up, talk a little bit about this, and we'll be back with our final thoughts in just a bit.
All right, welcome back. So, gentlemen, reviews, what do we think?
For me, I kind of want to take a page out of your book where you're talking about the cocktail. It reminds me of like drinking a Manhattan, not in the sense of the flavors, but where you're really just sitting and you're drinking it because you want to drink it. You're enjoying the beverage for what it is. It's got tons of different kinds of flavors, and the way that it's balanced reminded me of drinking a drink like that. And it's not something that I could drink probably more than one or two.
Yeah.
But it was great. I really enjoyed this beer.
Yeah, it's very, very rich in the alcohol content. I think one is perfect, just sip on it. But, you know, and as this warmed up, it took on a more kind of bitter taste to it, orange peel-esque. And I think the old-fashioned cocktail was still there. But I think it's very important to, especially with these bigger winter beers, to, you know, let them warm up and see how it changes. And, you know, I mean, I think it changed a lot more than most beers.
Yeah, it did. Yeah.
I actually, as it warmed up, as you were saying, I liked the citrusy taste to it. Definitely more of the citrus. The cherry flavor came out a little bit more. And you really enjoy it as you let it sit there. And you just, even if you're having one, as you let it progress, it definitely comes out. If you like the citrus taste and you like a little cherry flavor, it's definitely a great beer for it.
Yeah. You know what I liked about it? It being a great winter brew, it was nice and smooth, but it wasn't overdone with spices and all kinds of different tastes. You know what I mean? It was the tastes were very subtle,
and it's not even overdone with alcohol content. I'd say even at 8.5, it seems like a lot, but it doesn't taste like an 8.5.
No,
it's easy to drink.
That's right. So.
Which is cool. Good and dangerous all at the
yes,
same time.
Like we said before, Frozen Pasture is brewed by Bolero Snort Brewing Company. It can currently be found at the Grove Wine and Spirits in Hamilton, Gleason's Discount Liquor in Ocean View, and it's available on tap at Poor Henry's Pub in Montville, Rockefeller Sports Bar in East Rutherford, and to see the full availability and learn more about this beer, you can click on the link right above Mr. Frank Cerdo, right there.
All right, well, that's another episode of New Jersey Craft Beer Review. I'm Chris Swenderman with Chris Anucci, Dan Tantillo, Frank Sertel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.
Cheers.
Cheers.